1 year after the military seized power, a sign that the resistance is alive and well. The streets of the main city of Yangon empty. But this is not fear, it's defiance. Shops shuttered, businesses closed, many staying indoors in a so-called silent strike, the tactic used in the past, clearly angering the regime, with dozens arrested for their involvement.
The military is using their power to try to force shop owners to open. They're actually saying that if you don't open your shop, this could be considered a seditious activity.
In Mandalay, a hotbed of resistance, a flash mob appears and disappears just as quickly. Some protest too in Yangon. Small but powerful acts of defiance in the face of a regime that continues to kill, imprison and terrorise its citizens. On February 1, 2021, the democratically elected leader Aung San Suu Kyi and other government members were arrested in pre-dawn raids, the military roaring into the capital and seizing control of the country. In the days, weeks and months that followed, millions took to the streets, despite the increasingly deadly crackdown. Rights groups estimate 1,500 people have been killed and 11,000 arbitrarily imprisoned. And they say without immediate international intervention, the military's reign of terror will continue.
So this year, I think this will make it or break it, because last year it was pathetic. And if Myanmar turns into a so-called failed state, then we have that in our conscience.
The people of Myanmar are no longer taking to the streets in their tens of thousands, as they did in the early days of the coup. But the brutal campaign has galvanised a more robust resistance. People are boycotting military-owned companies. They're refusing to pay their electricity bills. The regime's budget shrinking. And so too, its military ranks. Thousands of defections said to have taken place over the past 12 months. And an increasing number of civilians taking up arms. Supporters in Australia say it's kill or be killed.
The people in Myanmar, they don't have other choice because the military junta pushed them into a corner.
The people are resisting fearlessly. 6 months ago, we wouldn't have thought that junta could fail, but now I think they are close to failing.
But rights groups say more international action is needed to pressure the regime. The US, Britain and Canada today imposing sanctions on a further three senior military officials. Washington separately imposing measures against companies accused of providing financial support to the junta. Australia facing renewed pressure, but Foreign Minister Maurice Payne today stopping short. In a statement, she said, the military has inflicted horrific violence, trampled basic freedoms, and triggered humanitarian, security, health, and economic crises across the country. We urge the military to exercise restraint and to release all those arbitrarily detained, including Australian Professor Sean Turnell. The Australian academic and advisor to Aung San Suu Kyi was arrested in the wake of the coup. 12 months on, he's still imprisoned. His future, like that of the country, remains in the balance 1 year on. Abby O'Brien, SBS World News.